Good morning, children. So we are back again with another topic from geography. Next chapter is water. So you have learned what is lithosphere. You learned what is atmosphere, and the water bodies you call as hydrosphere. You have learned about the three domains of the earth: lithosphere, atmosphere, and hydrosphere. So you are learning about hydrosphere. Why do you see water, isn't it? Hydrosphere means all the water bodies that you see on the earth's surface. Which are the water bodies that you see on the earth's surface? It includes oceans, seas, then lakes, rivers. All these are water bodies. All these together you say as water bodies. And even snow and ice are also come under these water bodies, which you call in one term as hydrosphere. So what is the importance of this hydrosphere? What is the importance of water, and what's the importance of hydrosphere? So all these water bodies, whichever water body we mentioned earlier, all these water bodies are very much necessary for the existence of life on the earth. So without water, life is quite impossible. Even plants, animals, and human beings need water for their existence, and earth is the only planet which has water or water bodies, and that is why you call earth as a watery planet, and that is the only reason why life exists on earth. So then water in different forms, it also act as a cooling agent of the atmosphere. See, we feel cold, or we have a moderating experience, we have a moderating climatic condition, mainly because we have these water bodies on the earth. And see, these water bodies also help in the promotion of trade also, and see, it provides us food also, like fish. All these are being provided by these water bodies. So water bodies are very important for the existence of life. And see, 71% of the area of the earth's surface is covered by water, and only 29% comprises of land. So that is why you call earth as a watery planet. You always call earth as a watery planet because of the more amount of water that is being found on earth. Now, see, you can see fresh water as well as saline water. Among these water bodies, some water bodies are fresh waters and some are saline water. What do you mean by saline water? What is salinity? Salinity means it is the amount of salt that in grams present in 1000 grams of water. In 1000 grams of water, how much amount of salt is present? That is called as salinity of water. So you know, ocean water and sea water are saline water, and this water is not useful for our daily life, or it cannot be used in our daily life. So 97% of the water bodies are of the water body comprises of saline water, which cannot be used in our daily life. So only 3% comprises of fresh water. And so from this figures you will be understanding that the amount of fresh water is very much limited, and there is no other source from where we are getting water. So it is a must that we have to preserve and conserve this fresh water resources, because if we contaminate our fresh water, there will not be a water existing for the daily existence, and it's a major ingredient that is being necessary for the existence of life on earth. So why are ocean waters saline? You told ocean water and sea water is always salty. Or what makes this ocean and sea water salty? And you know, all these water bodies empty their water in ocean and seas. So as they pass by these rivers and other water bodies, while flowing, they pass over the earth's surface. They carry various amount of salt that is being found on the surface of the earth. And as it deposits its water in ocean, the salt is also deposited along with the water and other ingredients while emptying its water in the ocean. So this makes the ocean water saline or salty. And this amount of salinity, it depends upon the rate of evaporation and as well as the amount of fresh water that is being added to the ocean. So that is why ocean water is always salinity. And I told there is a need for preservation and conservation of this fresh water because it is limited in quantity. And water cycle already you have learned. And what is water cycle? Water cycle is the process by which continually changes its form and it circulates between ocean and atmosphere and land, isn't it? Water evaporated from water bodies, they rise higher up in the sky, condenses there, fall down as rainfall. This water will be flowing back to ocean and seas, and again the same process continues again and again. This cyclical process you call as water cycle. So this move and see again related to the ocean water, if we say this ocean water, it is always keeping on moving. It always, although it is saline, it also has a number of uses also. There are a number of uses also for this ocean water. This ocean water, it modifies the climate, or it modifies the high temperature that we have in the summer season. Then it modifies our climatic conditions. It's a source of food for navigation, isn't it? So or for all this purpose you use ocean water. Now see, this ocean water always keeps on moving, and according to the movement of this ocean water, it is classified or divided into three. They are waves, tides and ocean currents. Waves, tides and ocean currents, these are the classification of ocean water according to its movement. So ocean water, ocean and sea water does not remain still, it keeps on moving. So according to the movement, they are divided into three. They are waves, tides and ocean currents. So water, waves, the up and down movement of water that you see in an ocean or water body is called as waves, and these waves are usually formed because of the pushing action of the wind. So because of the pressure of wind, the topmost layer of the water will be moving up and down. That means they will be rising up and falling down. This up and down movement is called as waves, and usually these waves are found only on the surface of the water, and it vary in size as well as in height. According to the strength of the wind. It may be if the wind is very strong, the size of wave will be very high, and if the wind is if it is not a very strong wind, the size of wave will also be very less. So according to the wind, according to the speed of wind and according to the weather condition, waves may be mild or as well as strong. And these waves always make an up and down movement only, but it does not move forward like a river. Like the rivers flowing forward, it does not flow or it does not move forward, but it only make up and down movements. And you can feel it, this up and down movement while standing by the shore. You can see the up and down movement of this water, which is found only on the surface of the water. And see, if there is a very strong wind, you can see very high waves, and these high waves, according to the speed of the wind, the waves can be stronger and it can cause a lot of havoc to life and property also. Then there are volcanic eruptions, then earthquakes, and these formations inside the ocean and sea water may be pushing large volume of water towards the earth, which you call as tsunamis. And the tsunamis are the ones which cause a lot of destruction to life and property. In your textbook, case studies is given related to tsunami. You can read it and understand what are the destruction that has been occurred or formed as a result of tsunami. So I hope you understood what are waves, what are the uses of ocean, what you mean by salinity, why ocean water is saline, what are the uses of water. Then all these things you learn, what is water cycle, all this you have learned. So tides and ocean currents you will be learning in the next class. Thank you.